Hey, in this video I'd like to present the fish shell, which is a modern alternative to bash and zsh. So generally when you go on Linux, the default shell is often bash, and you can customize it a little bit, but not that much. So then you move to zsh, but zsh is really a mess. And when you get tired of it, you go to fish. So that's the path I took, at least. But yeah. And why do I say modern is because, yeah, there is a lot of built-in stuff in fish that in ZSH you have to work for it. And also, yeah, if you quickly glance at the code base of ZSH versus fish, yeah, fish is... just normal code, and ZSH is a nightmare. So yeah, the only downside of fish is that it's not POSIX compliant, and if you don't care, like if you don't write shell scripts, you don't care about this. But like it means like there is a standard between bash and ZSH, and fish doesn't, or like other shells, and fish doesn't respect it for I guess good reasons, but yeah, that's the only downside in my opinion. So this is how it looks like, just pretty normal stuff. I've customized it like this. You can have aliases, you can have abbreviation, like if I put this and then space, it expands to something. I'll just quickly go through my configuration and show you how you can customize it. So the config file is in config fish, and then config.fish. So config fish fish.conf. Oh wait, config.fish. Yes. So yeah, at the first glance, you can actually already see that it's a bit different, but it's not that bad. So the if, it's not fi at the end, it's an and, which makes more sense. Instead of export a variable, you use set gx. You can still execute commands, of course. The condition is still between square brackets, like. It's not too bad. So here I set a bunch of variables to config variables, which is not that interesting. And then that's a nice thing in fish actually. It can detect if it's an interactive shell or it's a shell that is used to run a script, because maybe you want something for like aesthetics, but like you don't care about that when you run a script. So if you do if status is interactive, it will only be when you actually use it as a human. And the first thing I did is fish v key bindings, because it has built-in key bindings. There is also that in bash and zsh, but if you use vim and you like the key bindings, you can use in your shell prompts, and it makes a world of difference. Meaning that you can just do start typing command foo bar, and then you can press escape and go back with the vim movement, go there and go to the start and happen at the end. Like anything you can do in vim, you can select text with v, delete it, anything you want to do, just like in vim, and it's built into fish. Next, I have a little function fish greetings that is empty. This is just because by default fish is a random greeting message, and I want my shell to be just simple and minimal, so remove that. Next, you can set aliases just like in bash or zsh, just that's pretty self-explanatory, I think. But then there is a little subtlety which come here, which is you can declare abbreviation. And the difference between aliases and abbreviation is just that an alias is just an alias like in bash or in ZSH, but an abbreviation will actually, if you press a space after you enter it, it will expand it. So if I do here, you saw abre LL. So if I do LL, then space, you see it expands to the thing I want. It's actually nice to, I don't know, I use it. It's easier to search in the history or to show what you're actually doing under the hood of the alias, or maybe like enter the alias and then quickly modify it to have a slightly different version. Then abbreviation, a lot of abbreviation. What else is interesting in there? That's for my theme, because it doesn't come as like this out of the box, but I'll show how to install that later. Yes, this is for, like, if you're, like, on Debian or Ubuntu, I think that's by default, but, like, if you type a command that is not installed, it will show you in which in which package you need to install to have that command. And here, I don't think it's built in into fish, so you need to have a function that is a fish command not found that will return a list of package. All that will be executed when a command is not found. But here I'm on Arch Linux, and on Arch Linux, this is how you do it with a package file, which says where that executables is in which package. I know on Debian or Ubuntu it's something different. It's command underscore not underscore found, I think. You can probably look that up. But you would have something similar. And yeah, that's basically it for the configuration. Next, I would like to show how you can have plugins. And for that, there is a package manager called Fisher, which you can install by just copy-pasting this in your terminal. Yes, curl into a shell is very safe, and you should always do it without ever looking at the content of the script, of course. So you do that and pray, and then you can just do a Fisher install and some plugins. My plugins that I have, I only have a few. Fisher. So I have Pure Fish, which is my theme. There is also actually this theme for ZSH as well. So, and it's, it's, as you saw, it's a very clean team. There is Fish ZSH and Colored Man. So, you can do Fisher list to list the install package, and then Fisher install to install a package. Of course, this one is already installed, but yeah. Fish Colored Man is because, I don't know, the man page don't look good in Fish for some reason. I mean, they do in Bash and ZSH, but anyway, I just wanted that when I do man tree something, that I actually have a sweet color highlighting in the man pages. This is very important for my sanity. It's a stupid detail, but it's a nice plugin. The Pure, you already said what it is, and the FZF, if you don't know what FZF, the FZF Fuzzy Finder, the program is, it's pretty simple. It's a command line utility that will list a bunch of stuff, and then you can start typing and it fuzzy finds on it, and if you press enter, it outputs this to the output. And there is plenty of tool, like I know Vim, you can use it in Vim, you can integrate it in your shell, you can integrate it in a bunch of stuff. And there is an integration with Fish. And I know you can go into directory with this extension, but the main reason I use it is to have the control R, that in Bash is a search in history, which I use all the time. But here you can do control R, and you can fuzzy search in your history. So let's say commit, and I did a commit like this, and then enter, and yeah. And it's much more powerful than the Bash reverse search, because Bash reverse search is actually only followed Like say it's an exact match. It's contains, but here you can have typos or I don't know, not matching cases, and it will still find it. Also, it's a bit prettier. But to do that, you have to have FZF install, of course, and you can probably do apt install FZF or pacman SYU s FZF. Just you need to have this install. And I think I only use it for the search in history, but there is, yeah, apparently if you type vim, it can you can search a file to open in vim git diff. You can search, I should actually look into this, that looks cool. But I don't know if it's actually useful. Maybe, yeah, you instead of so, I mean, I'm rambling at this point, but okay, no, that doesn't work. Anyway, but it's a cool plugin. Actually, I should maybe replace CD by this, could be nice. But yeah, that's it. That's all the plugins and configuration I use for my shell, and I'm pretty happy with it that I switched from ZSH to this. So yeah. I will put in the description my configuration files if you're interested. So, yeah, that's it. See you.